Morning. You're up early.
Oh, got delivery at the bar, so I thought I'd go in soon. Might go shopping later. Spend some of my hard-earned cash.
Do you want coffee?
Yes, please. Did you sleep okay?
Yeah, fine.
Both of us are terrible liars. Come on, be honest, neither of us slept a wink last night.
What are you talking about?
Well, I don't know about you, but I just couldn't stop thinking about those phone calls.
Well, don't.
How can you say that?
Because it's just some nutter. Doctors get them all the time. It goes with the territory. Ben's had one, Carly's had one. So you can relax, okay? Now, it's Katrina's housewarming party tonight, so you can think about getting her something suitably retro when you're shopping, yeah?
Hello? Faith? Fainted. Another one. Okay, I'll come and check him now. Bye.
Don't worry, this happens more often than you think. The doctor will just take a quick look at him.
Hello there. Another one fall at your feet, Nurse Walker?
Afraid so.
Adam, wake up.
I gave him a hep B jab and he just keeled over.
Mm-hmm. What's wrong? Why did he faint?
Do we have any atropine of 500 micrograms, please?
Yeah.
Okay. Has this happened before?
No. Well, we were running through the woods, but... Adam, are you okay?
Yeah. What did you do to me?
Hi, I'm Dr. Carlyle. You just fainted. You may have had a reaction to the injection.
I didn't have any breakfast. Maybe my blood sugars are low.
You sure you're okay?
And this definitely hasn't happened before?
Of course not.
I guess it's a good job you fainted here then, isn't it?
Oh, no, you don't. You've just fainted. Whether it's your blood sugars or not, you're not going anywhere for at least 15 minutes. Faith, can you get Adam some juice? Then I'll check you over fully in my room.
That's enough. I can't refuse.
Glad to hear it. Come in. Oh. Hello. Is everything all right?
Yeah, I just came to apologise for my brother and to say that he's gone home.
Oh?
Well, I tried to stop him, but he sneaked out.
Well, really, he should be resting.
Yeah, actually, this isn't the first time this has happened.
Ah. Take a seat.
Thanks.
Why didn't Adam tell me this?
Oh, well, you see, our dad died last year of a heart attack.
I'm sorry.
I'm really worried. Do you think this fainting could be related? I mean, with what happened to Dad?
Well, possibly, but it's no good speculating until I've examined Adam properly.
It's just that we're supposed to be going climbing in Tanzania in a couple of weeks, so...
Well, really, he should get checked over if he's going somewhere at such a high altitude.
I keep telling him, but every time our kid brother comes to stay with us, God, they keep egging each other on. They're like a couple of kids.
I can't help Adam if he doesn't want me to. Try and persuade him that it'd be a good idea to come back and see me, will you?
I'll try.
Okay.
Thanks.
Bye. Hi, Sean. Hi, it's me, Jude. Yep, fine. Listen, I think we should meet. How about tonight? Yep, 7:30's fine. Uh-huh. Yeah, I'll find it. I'll see you then. Okay, bye.
Isn't a low pulse rate a sign of fitness?
Not always. Repeated fainting spells suggest more than just a regular bradycardia.
What's that?
It's a heart rate of less than 60 beats per minute, and you're in the mid-50s.
Mid-50s? Our dad died in his mid-50s. He was 54.
That's young. It's been tough on you. There's a slight irregularity to your heartbeat. The atria are beating normally, but the ventricles are lagging behind.
What does that mean?
You have a second-degree heart block. That's what's been causing you to faint. Your heart may skip a beat or the ventricles just can't get enough blood out.
Does that mean I'm going to have a heart attack?
No, not necessarily. Heart block is quite common. If I'm right, you should be able to lead a perfectly normal life.
We're going to Tanzania in a couple of weeks. We're going to take our dad's ashes and we're going to spread them all over the mountain.
It's a lovely gesture.
He was born there. He was going to go back and climb Kilimanjaro. I was going to go with him. But then,
I understand, and it could still be possible. But Adam, there are aspects of your lifestyle that you'll need to take a look at. A healthier diet, less saturated fats.
I do exercise regularly.
Uh-huh, and that's great, but you need to look at all aspects of your life. If you're going to start climbing mountains or doing extreme sports, you may need to consider something else.
What else?
Probably a pacemaker.
A pacemaker? What am I going to tell my brothers?
Well, it's all right to admit that there's a problem. Count yourself lucky you've got brothers who care about you. If you'd have fainted at altitude, and you would have, you could have risked far greater problems. And there's something else, isn't there? Stress. Luke told me you've been having a difficult time recently.
After Dad died, Mum and Pete went to pieces. I've just been trying to hold everyone together. It was easier to worry about them than think about what was going on in my life. My girlfriend Rachel chucking me out, trying to make the business work. But then Dad always used to say, if anything happens to me, you're in charge, Adam. You're the number one son. I didn't have a choice. Who else was going to do it? And I wake up every morning and I think he's still alive, and then I realize he isn't. And then I've got to make sure that Pete does his studies and Mum doesn't break down during the day and Luke has made the right travel arrangements, and it's just too much. And all the time I want to ask Dad what to do next, but I can't. And I'm afraid I'm going to go the same way he went. But I can't let them down, can I?
No, but they can be there for you too.